Good morning. This morning I'm going to sing hymn 86, How Great Thou Art. Then I'm going to read Book of Mormon pages 404 to 406, Helaman 15 verse 8 through 16 verse 15. Then I'll read New Testament pages 1228 to 1230, Matthew chapter 23 verse 13 to 24 verse 8. O Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees. When I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And when I think that God his Son not sparing sent him to die, I scarce can take it in, that on the cross my burden gladly bearing, he bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Book of Mormon, pages 404 to 406, Helaman chapter 15, verse 8 to chapter 16, verse 15. Therefore, as many as have come to this, ye know of yourselves are firm and steadfast in the faith, and in the thing wherewith they have been made free. And you know also that they have buried their weapons of war, and they fear to take them up, lest by any means they should sin. Yea, you can see that they fear to sin, For behold, they will suffer themselves to be trodden down and slain by their enemies, and will not lift their swords against them, and this because of their faith in Christ. And now, because of their steadfastness, when they do believe in that thing which they do believe, for because of their firmness, when they are once enlightened, behold, the Lord shall bless them and prolong their days, notwithstanding their iniquity. Yea, even if they should dwindle in unbelief, the Lord shall prolong their days, until the time shall come which hath been spoken of by our fathers, and also by the prophet Zenos, and many other prophets, concerning the restoration of our brethren, the Lamanites, again to the knowledge of truth. Yea, I say unto you, that in the latter times the promises of the Lord have been extended to our brethren, the Lamanites, and notwithstanding the many afflictions which they shall have, and notwithstanding they shall be driven to and fro upon the face of the earth, and be hunted, and shall be smitten, and scattered abroad, having no place for refuge, the Lord shall be merciful unto them. And this is according to the prophecy, that they shall again be brought to the true knowledge, which is the knowledge of their Redeemer, and their great and true Shepherd, and be numbered among his sheep. Therefore I say unto you, it shall be better for them than for you, except you repent. For behold, had the mighty works been shown unto them which have been shown unto you, yea, unto them who have dwindled in unbelief because of the traditions of their fathers, ye conceive yourselves that they never would again have dwindled in unbelief. Therefore saith the Lord, I will not utterly destroy them, but I will cause that in the day of my wisdom they shall return again unto me, saith the Lord. And now behold, saith the Lord, concerning the people of the Nephites, if they will not repent and observe to do my will, I will utterly destroy them, saith the Lord, because of their unbelief, notwithstanding the many mighty works which I have done among them. And as surely as the Lord liveth, shall these things be, saith the Lord. The book of Helaman, chapter 16. The Nephites who believe Samuel are baptized by Nephi. Samuel cannot be slain with the arrows and stones of the unrepentant Nephites. Some harden their hearts, and others see angels. The unbelievers say it is not reasonable to believe in Christ and his coming in Jerusalem, about 6 through 1 BC. And now it came to pass that there were many who heard the words of Samuel the Lamanite, which he spake upon the walls of the city. And as many as believed on his words went forth and sought for Nephi. And when they had come forth and found him, they confessed unto him their sins, and denied not, desiring that they might be baptized unto the Lord. But as many as there were who did not believe in the words of Samuel were angry with him, and they cast stones at him upon the wall, and also many shot arrows at him as he stood upon the wall. But the Spirit of the Lord was with him, insomuch that they could not hit him with their stones, neither with their arrows. Now when they saw that they could not hit him, there were many more who did believe on his words, insomuch that they went away unto Nephi to be baptized. For behold, Nephi was baptizing, and prophesying, and preaching, crying repentance unto the people, showing signs and wonders, working miracles among the people, that they might know that the Christ must surely come. Telling them of things which must shortly come, that they might know and remember at the time of their coming, that they had been made known unto them beforehand, to the intent that they might believe. Therefore, as many as believed on the words of Samuel went forth unto him to be baptized, for they came repenting and confessing their sins. But the more part of them did not believe in the words of Samuel. Therefore, when they saw that they could not hit him with their stones and their arrows, they cried unto their captain, saying, Take this fellow and bind him, for behold, he hath a devil, and because of the power of the devil which is in him, we cannot hit him with our stones and our arrows. Therefore take him and bind him, and away with him. And as they went forth to lay their hands on him, behold, he did cast himself down from the wall, and did flee out of their lands, yea, even unto his own country. And he began to preach and to prophesy among his own people. And behold, he was never heard of more among the Nephites. And thus were the affairs of the people. And thus ended the 86th year of the reign of the judges over the people of Nephi. And thus ended also the 87th year of the reign of the judges. And the more part of the people remaining in their pride and wickedness, and the lesser part walking more circumspectly before God. And these were the conditions also in the 88th year of the reign of the judges. And there was but little alteration in the affairs of the people, save it were the people began to be more hardened in iniquity, and do more and more of that which was contrary to the commandments of God, in the 89th year of the reign of the judges. But it came to pass in the 90th year of the reign of the judges, there were great signs given unto the people, and wonders, and words of the prophets began to be fulfilled. And angels did appear unto men, wise men, and did declare unto them glad tidings of great joy. Thus in this year scriptures began to be fulfilled. Nevertheless, the people began to harden their hearts, all save it were the most believing part of them, both of the Nephites and also of the Lamanites, and they began to depend on their own strength and their own wisdom. New Testament, pages 1228 to 1230, Matthew chapter 23, verse 13 to 24, verse 8. But woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you shut up the kingdom of God of heaven against men. For ye neither go in yourselves, neither suffer ye them that are entering to go in. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye devour widows' houses, and for a pretense make long prayer. Therefore ye shall receive the greater damnation. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye compass sea and land to make one proselyte, and when he is made, ye make him twofold more the child of hell than yourselves. Woe unto you, ye blind guides, which say, whosoever shall swear by the temple, it is nothing, but whosoever shall swear by the gold of the temple, he is a debtor. Ye fools and blind, for whether is greater the gold, or the temple that sanctifieth the gold? And whosoever shall swear by the altar, it is nothing, but whosoever sweareth by the gift that is upon it, he is guilty. Ye fools and blind, for whether is greater the gift, or the altar that sanctifieth the gift? Whoso therefore shall swear by the altar, sweareth by it and by all things thereon. And whoso shall swear by the temple, sweareth by it and by him that dwelleth therein. And if he that shall swear by heaven, sweareth by the throne of God and by him that sitteth thereon. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for ye pay tithe of mint and anise and cumin, and have omitted the weightier matters of the law, judgment, mercy, and faith. These ought ye to have done, and not to leave the other undone. Ye blind guides, which strain at a gnat and swallow a camel. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you make clean the outside of the cup and of the platter, but within they are full of extortion and excess. Thou blind Pharisee, cleanse first that which is within the cup and platter, that the outside of them may be clean also. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, for you are like unto whited sepulchres, which indeed appear beautiful outward, but are within full of dead men's bones and of all uncleanness. Even so ye also outwardly appear righteous unto men, but within ye are full of hypocrisy and iniquity. Woe unto you, scribes and Pharisees, hypocrites, because ye build the tombs of the prophets and garnish the sepulchres of the righteous, and say, if we had been in the days of our fathers, we would not have been partakers with them in the blood of the prophets. Wherefore ye be witnesses unto yourself that ye are the children of them which killed the prophets. Fill ye up, then, the measure of your fathers. Ye serpents, ye generation of vipers, how can ye escape the damnation of hell? Wherefore, behold, I send unto you prophets and wise men and scribes, and some of them ye shall kill and crucify, and some of them shall ye scourge in your synagogues and persecute them from city to city, that upon you may come all the righteous blood shed upon the earth, from the blood of righteous Abel unto the blood of Zacharias, son of Barachias, whom ye slew between the temple and the altar. Verily I say unto you, all these things shall come upon this generation. O Jerusalem, Jerusalem, thou that killest the prophets and stonest them which are sent unto thee, how oft would I have gathered thy children together, even as a hen gathereth her chickens under her wings, and you would not. Behold, your house is left unto you desolate. For I say unto you, ye shall not see me henceforth, till ye shall say, Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. St. Matthew chapter 24. Jesus foretells the doom of Jerusalem and the destruction of the temple. Great calamities will precede his second coming. He gives the parable of the fig tree. And Jesus went out and departed from the temple, and his disciples came to him to shew him the buildings of the temple. And Jesus said unto them, See ye not all these things? Verily I say unto you, there shall not be left here one stone upon another that shall not be thrown down. And as he sat upon the Mount of Olives, the disciples came unto him privately, saying, Tell us, when shall these things be? And what shall be the sign of thy coming and of the end of the world? And Jesus answered and said unto them, Take heed that no man deceive you. For many shall come in my name, saying, I am Christ, and shall deceive many. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nation shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilences and earthquakes in divers places. All these are the beginning of sorrows. Our kind and gracious Father in heaven, we're so grateful for the beautiful music that has been written, for the opportunity to sing and worship and to praise thy name and to exercise our ability to focus on thee and keep an eye single to thy glory. We are so grateful for the sacrifice of the Savior and for the blessings which that brings into our lives, healing that comes because of it, physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually. And we pray that we might live our lives in a way that those blessings might come to their greatest fruition. We ask blessing upon our family members and pray that they know of our love and pray that they too know of thy love and have a desire to come unto thee. We pray for the things which we are reading in the scriptures, that we might understand them and might be able to prepare ourselves to be ready for the things that are to come, that we might have our hearts cleansed and broken and open to thy guidance. Bless it, the leaders of the church, that they might be blessed with health and strength and the love and inspiration, the peace and joy that comes through thy service. Bless the leaders of our nation, that they might have the wisdom and clarity and the guidance to make decisions that will bless us as we strive to keep our priorities and do the things that thou would have us do. Bless the service men and women who have dedicated their lives to our safety and to upholding the Constitution and protecting us from those whose intentions are not Christ-like. We're grateful for all we have. We're grateful for the love that is poured out upon us and for our home and family, and ask blessing upon those who are less fortunate, those who are striving to just make ends meet and simply survive, and that they might be blessed with their needs, with shelter, with food, with the services that will help them to be healthy and well. And ask a blessing upon the loved ones that are not with us, that they might know of our love truly. And we say these things in the name of thy Son, Jesus Christ. Amen.